This map contains a feature layer, countries, and a standalone table, globalfloodrisk.csv. The CSV file is considered a standalone table because it only contains tabular data. This contrasts with feature layers like countries, which have both spatial information, the shapes visible on the map, and tabular information, the attribute table. In this lesson, you'll join fields from the CSV to the countries layer so you can visualize flood risk on the map. First, you'll find matching fields from both layers. The CSV contains a country name field. The countries layer contains many fields for country names. Each one is formatted differently. You must find the one that best matches the country field in the CSV. In the CSV, Egypt Arab Republic stands out as an example of formatting. On the map, click Egypt. Name underscore sort is the only field in the countries layer that formats the name of Egypt the same way as the CSV. Check some of the other countries. Of all the country name fields, name underscore sort provides the best fit. You'll attempt to join the two tables using the matching values in the country and name underscore sort fields. In the contents pane, right-click countries, point to joins and relates, and click add join. For input table, choose countries. This is the layer that will receive the joined fields. For join table, choose globalfloodrisk.csv. This is the layer that will provide the joined fields. Choose name underscore sort and country for the join fields. The join operation will only be able to join records where the name underscore sort and country fields match. Uncheck keep all target features. This will make it easier to find out which countries did not match. Click OK. The map has changed its appearance. Some countries are missing because they are not included in the CSV, but others are missing because their names didn't match. There are 163 rows in the CSV table. There are 159 rows in the countries table. This means there are four countries that were not matched. Scroll to the end of the countries table to find the three fields joined from the CSV. Sort the rank column and scroll to find the gaps in the numbers. There are gaps at 18, 94, 141, and 158. In the CSV, these numbers correspond to the United States, Czech Republic, Swaziland, and Brunei Darussalam. In the countries layer, they have different names. These countries were not joined because their names did not match exactly. You'll remove the join and edit the names in one of the tables to make them match. In the contents pane, right-click countries, point to joins and relates, and click remove all joins. In the catalog pane, on the project tab, expand the river floods folder. Right-click globalfloodrisk.csv and click show in file explorer. Open the CSV with Notepad or another text editor. Find row 18 and edit the text to replace United States with United States of America. Edit the names of the other countries that failed to match as well. Save and close the CSV file. In ArcGIS Pro, refresh the CSV table to display the edited country names. Now you can try the join again. This time, you'll keep all target features. Click Validate Join. Check the message window to confirm that all 163 records will be matched. Click OK. In the Countries table, scroll to the end and confirm that the three new fields are present. Finally, you'll visualize one of the join fields on the map. For field, choose current annual average population affected by river floods. Because this field represents a count, the symbology should be normalized. you'll divide the affected population by the total population. The map shows the highest per capita river flood risk is in Bangladesh. In this lesson, you'll learn the following skills: how to find matching fields across two tables, how to join fields from one table to another, how to assess the success of a join, how to remove a join, and how to edit a standalone table and refresh its view in ArcGIS Pro.